So in allergy conditions, the discharge will be for immediate heart failure for the patient to ophthalmologist. Otherwise, you can treat it by antibiotics. Next slide. So the another important thing like in trauma patients or severe coughing and viral conjunctivitis, you can say the subconjunctival hemorrhage. It's a bleeding between the conjunctiva and the sclera. So this type of patients no need for referral. Like this, it resolves by without stapling. So no need for treatment. Sometimes it needs treatment when the SCH extends beyond the cornea. Okay. Otherwise, it involves associated ocular structure trauma. Then you should refer the patient to ophthalmologist. So if it is involved beyond the cornea, we have the rule of base of the skull fracture. Next slide. So the patients are present to you with the like my eye is not straight. Then what can we do? Like the symptoms are very acute. We have to think of paralytic pain. Commonly diabetes and hypertension causes isolated third arm and system palsy. So the so your patients may be present with like ptosis. Third nerve palsy will cause ptosis and restricted ocular motility. Sixth nerve palsy will cause restricted abduction. And next slide. So next, the popular and most common like recent advancement in ophthalmology, LASIK. So what is? So any patients like everyone want to wear freedom from glasses from the childhood to above 40 or 60. Everyone do not want to wear specs. Okay. So this is called next slide. So the history starts from like tradition says that and Chinese left with fan packs in their eyes to flatten their cornea. The same principle is applied now. Okay. So next slide. So what is LASIK? So LASIK means L for laser assisted in situ keratomyosis. So it's a procedure that permanently changes the corneal curvature. So and the total is using the excimer laser. So the wavelength is 193 nanometer UV wavelength. So the total procedure time is on each day maximum 2 to 5 minutes. The laser timing is 30 seconds, less than 30 seconds. So totally naked procedure. So these are the two machines we are using for the LASIK. The first one is excimer laser station. This one is a femtosecond laser. So it does the intralytic LASIK. That means plate-free LASIK. In LASIK there are two techniques, plate LASIK and plate-free LASIK. We will discuss about in the next slide. So it's totally done under local anesthesia, topical anesthesia. So it's a painless, totally painless. So the first, there are five steps. The first step is you have to apply the topical anesthesia on the eye. Then we have to create the vacuum. Like we have to increase the intraocular pressure to maintain the eye structure. So we have to increase the intraocular pressure to 65 millimeter mercury by using a vacuum. The next step is to create the corneal flap. In cornea we have five layers. So we have to create one third thickness like 120 microns or 160 microns flap. So total thickness, intercorneal thickness is a max. Average is 550. So we have to create corneal flap that runs by either microkerato or femtosecond laser. That's the difference between blade laser and blade free laser. And blade laser we are using microkerato to create to make the corneal flap. In bladeless LASIK we are using femtosecond laser to make the flap. That is the difference between blade and blade. So other steps are similar to both. So other steps are we have to fold the flap to expose the stroma. So stroma is ablated by the excimer laser. So by the ablating the stroma tissue, we are making the power, we are correcting the power. So again the flap is repositioned. Next, we are going to see a small video about LASIK. LASIK. So, animated video. So, topical anesthesia is applied. So, this is increasing intraocular pressure by vacuum. This is microkerato. In intralytic LASIK, we are using femtosecond laser to make the flap. Now the flap is folded. So very convenient to the patient and doctor both, because everything is done by the machine and technology.
Advantage of 50 microns are there with
instruction. You can save like 50 microns.
Is there any place or stabilizer?
Some people, they still do. I mean,
they do, but is there any place that...
Yeah, definitely.
You have recurrence? Once you undergo elastic procedure, is it permanent?
It's a permanent, sir. It's lifelong.
There is any deficiency, you can redo that.
Yeah, any enhancement option is
there. Always.
Contraindications, if the patients have progressive myopia, like beyond 18 also they are not having stable refraction, or if myopia is progressing or pathological myopia, we do not treat. And the patients with any retinal problem or like keratoconus patients, any cornea disorder, dystrophy, we cannot treat the patient by LASIK.
Local.
Local is there. Thank you.